Apocalypse's arrival fell a little flat, but changes are on the way. We got a statement from the devs that we're going to talk about in this video. We also have an update dropping this week, and in this video, we're also previewing update 7.0 and everything that we know so far about this update. And it is Monday, and even though we are on vacation, we are answering all of your questions for the mailbag. And if you're ready for all of that, Valley Club, then you know what to do. Find that like button and let's go smash it.
Valley Flyer.
Hello, Valley Maniacs. What is up? Welcome back to the Valley Flying channel. I'm Valley Flying. Hope you're having a great day. We have update 7.0 coming this week in Marvel Strike Force. Will it be a hit or a miss? We're talking all about everything that we know so far coming in this update. We also have some changes to Apocalypse, and it is Monday, so we're going into the mailbag from Discord and answering all of your questions. But before we get to all that, though, if you haven't already subscribed, hit that subscribe button for more great Marvel Strike Force content. At least 5 Marvel Strike Force videos per week on this channel when we're not away for spring break. But hopefully this week we'll still get all the normal videos out because it is update week. There's a lot going on, and hopefully we can even film a weekly news update. Crossing our fingers for that one. But with all that said, let's get into these notes we just got for Apocalypse. And the dev said this: with the release of Apocalypse on March 10th, the dev team has closely been monitoring the character's performance in multiple game modes and reading players' feedback. So, and it kind of matches what we've seen on the test server. Looks to be really inconsequential on any mode in defense. So nothing on arena, nothing in war, nothing in crucible on defense, and not really consequential at all on offense in arena, and makes kind of a difference in crucible on offense and kind of a difference in war on offense, but not enough for this year-long chase. So I'm glad that they're looking at this, and I'm glad they're addressing this. Hopefully we got some changes to make him feel like that release that we wanted from that feeling that we got when we got the release of Ultron or Doctor Doom or Dormammu, just that big impactful character. Because I would compare this more to a Dark Dimension type release than a Legendary release. Those Legendaries are very, very good. So the team is currently discussing improvements to Apocalypse Kit to ensure he meets the expectations for such an important character, and that is good. My goodness, after this year-long chase, it'd be horrible to have this character fall flat on his face like this. This is our highest priority, and the team is moving quickly to ensure test several improvements followed by the time needed for balancing feedback and translation. So this is not something that we should expect very, very soon, but this is something that they are working on, so that is good. We'll keep you updated promptly this week as these improvements become solid. We'll try to as we tell you, we'll see them live in the game. We greatly appreciate your feedback, patience, and while we work to quickly address this, and I really like this. So hopefully Apocalypse will live up to the expectations. And there's a lot of players that apparently were quitting over this. So I'm not sure if the word gets out to them or if they're just done with the game. But let's talk about this update. We got an update coming this week in Marvel Strike Force. We have 6 new playable characters. We're going to come back to that. I do want to talk about these character updates, because we did get some notice of a character update that is happening in this latest blog post. It says, for the complete updates to Nick Fury, be sure to check out our upcoming 7.0 release notes. And this Nick Fury is going to be a part of this Invader team that is going to solve a skill raid section. So there should be a new raid coming that should be easier than the base level of Doom 3.3. So yeah, prepare. Rebirth is the next team on the way for bio, and this Invaders is the next team on the way for skill. Let's get back to these characters, though. Like I said, 6 new playable characters, and we do know about some of them from the blog post. We don't know about all of them, but I do wanted to highlight a few of these characters for you guys before these characters come to the game. First is a new version of Captain America. So not the Captain America in the game right now, a new World War II version. This one is a controller instead of a protector. And it does a lot of things for this kit. A couple things that I did want to highlight, though. On his special, he does flip all negative effects to positive effects for self and all Invader allies. So kind of a very strong move, you know, especially in the raids where you're getting a lot of negative effects potentially applied to your team. Turning those into positive effects is very, very good. And you have here on a death of Invader ally, generating an ability energy for all Invader allies. And then you also have a revive on Iron Fist kit. This could be a very, very powerful mechanic. So much in this passive here for the new Captain America. We also have Bucky Barnes, and this is not a Winter Soldier. This is actual Bucky Barnes here, part of this Invader team. He is the blaster of the team, or one of the blasters on the team, looking to supply that damage. And he has a very interesting interesting passive here. He's going to attack the primary target for damage. He's going to prolong all the negative effects except for Ability Block Stun and Trauma. If charged, he's also going to chain to the adjacent targets and he's going to prolong the negative effects on that target as well. But in the raids, he also is going to prolong Ability to Block Stun, Trauma, and he also does that on his ISO 8 and counter attack chance. So this is a very strong move. And not only does he do that for each charge, he's going to repeat this attack, and that is his ultimate attack. 300% damage, piercing damage against another adjacent target to a maximum of 5 adjacent targets. And how does he get all these charges? Well, at the start, on spawn, he's going to gain 8 charges. And anytime he does not have charge at the end of his turn, he's going to gain, he's going to apply offense damage to the enemies and he's going to gain 8 more charge. So pretty much always going to be charged if I'm reading this kit right. We'll have to see how this character works. But looks to be very, very strong addition to this Invaders team. This Iron Fist World War II is a support character keeping everybody alive. And this is a strong, strong ultimate, guys. It's attacking all enemies. So big AoE on his ultimate. Also in the raids, stun ability block, so providing some control for your team as well. He's going to revive a dead invader ally, 50% max health, and applying stun and 2 death proofs, and then he's going to heal everybody else. So this is a very strong ultimate, and if you have all the ability energy flying all over the place from Captain America, you could have this going off multiple times per match. It's a very, very strong move. Even well, a lot of it is tied to the raids, but outside of the raids, still very strong move as well. And then we got Union Jack as well as a second blaster on this team. Also has a very, very strong basic here, attacking the primary target, 300% damage, flipping positive effects into negative effects, and in the raid, so in your PvE content, 3 positive effects into negative effects. So these guys are very, very strong, and it looks to be the next solution. Now, we have been teased that Quicksilver is coming to Marvel Strike Force. It's going to be a Cosmic Crucible release. Now, that could be one of these 6 new playable characters, and if it is, that is 5. Let me know what you think the guess for that 6th is, though, because that is everything that we've been teased so far. Union Jack was teased in that strike time or in that wallpaper. He is official. Quicksilver was in that wallpaper. Not official, but most likely coming to the game. Let me know who you think that 6th one is. We also have some new costumes coming to the game, and we do have some costumes. We have a Doc Ock costume event going on right now, so that one will probably be released after this event, or we'll get the inbox matches for the leaderboards after the event. So that one's kind of released in the game. We also have that new Kestrel costume that was teased. Some of the blog posts looks very, very nice. What other costumes do we think is coming to this game, though? Hopefully it's something on a character that's usable and not some unusable character. Oh, we also have that Shield Medic, the male Shield Medic costume as well. Which, you know, that's the one that's an unusable character. So hopefully we get more characters, costumes and characters we could use, like Kestrel and things like that. All right, everything else, we have some Cosmic Crucible updates. Could this be a new season starting? We had Season 1 be delayed many times. Let me know what you think is happening in Cosmic Crucible. Is that wholesale changes? We are getting a new patch number going from 6.7 instead of going to 6.8. Instead of moving to the next 6 point, we're going to a new number going to 7.0. So this usually indicates there's a big change in the game. So let me know what you think is happening in Cosmic Crucible. Is that what's getting a big change in Marvel Strike Force when this new update drops, or is it something different? Is it a new season or something else? We also have some new additional challenges, which is good because we've had a level 90 level cap increase. We'd have a level 95 a little more recently. Neither of them had updates to these challenges. So if they are updating challenges, that is a good thing. We also got word, though, that on March 17th, which is in this next update, we're going to get a new pocket dimension. Now, the rewards here don't seem like they're super important, but any free rewards are good rewards, in my opinion. So gold ore fragment, training ore fragments, silver gold promotion credits, orange set catalyst, and some other things. No character releases, which is a little disappointing. So hopefully we get other things instead of just these challenges there. Now, we also have these new campaign chapters, and we know that we also are getting these new campaign chapters. We have them in the game right now as far as a preview. These are going live on March 15th, so when the update is dropping. And the reason that we know that this is when the update dropping is that they have a Red Star featuring Captain America, the new Captain America, who is not in the game yet. These are going to be live starting on March 15th. So this is how we know that that is when the update is dropping. So whenever this new update drops, we're also getting these new hard chapter campaigns. And more of all, what do we know that is more? Well, this is something that's a little disappointing. We have these new character availability updates. And over the past year, there have been several instances that they did not deliver two new characters per month and did not deliver a new character on the first Wednesday of the month. Well, what they said, they're not switching this. So now they're committed to ensuring, instead of two, one new character per month. So that is the change that we could expect in this next update. There's a good chance a second character release and a moderate chance a third. It's unlikely that these characters are going to be made available on the next Wednesday. So that is what we know is happening in this next update. Let's get to your questions from the mailbag. First question of the week. I have a question. Are going to get a baby apoc when he has an event? If not, how far they're going to get to a baby apocalypse? So we actually did unlock a baby apocalypse during his event. And this is what he looks like. So we haven't built him too much because he's not very useful right now, as we know. I got teams for Crucible, I got teams for War, so I don't really need him right now. And hopefully he doesn't fall into that apocalypse category, at least until his update drops. And hopefully when his update drops, he'll be in that Dormammu or Doomtide category. But that is where he is right now. I did manage to get him. That final push from getting some of these unlimited X-Men up to gear 17, finishing that apocalyptic difficulty, getting that extra ISO 8 was what I needed to get my ISO 8 blue 4 on Weaver, Kestrel, and Deathpool. So that gave me the final push. So if you are very close to leveling up one of your horsemen teams, that may give you the final push going through that apocalyptic difficulty. Although, and let's be honest, at this point you may want to wait until we get word of what his reworks are, and maybe get some testing in a game from some people, and then do all that stuff. But right now, if you don't have them, I wouldn't worry too much about it. Hey Valley, greetings from Singapore. Any advice on how to farm more L2 level 4 ions after 1 year plus hard year for completing all the monthly milestones? I failed to complete the Dazzler due to not getting any monthly item for a Gambit raid. Guessing scope leaves my eyes, my alliance sucks. With Apocalypse only 3 days away, I'll not be able to unlock him on day one. This feels extremely trashy, and it has reached my breaking point after a year of hard work. I still need T2 level 4 ions to do three characters. Deadpool, Phantom X, and Magneto. I think you mean Deathpool, but yeah. With only 3 days left, help. Well, the good thing, and I know it sucks because he should, after this much chase and after Apocalypse being this bad of a character, you should be able to unlock him. The good thing is these sagas aren't going away. So it's not like a normal legendary event where it only pops up and it goes away. Once you have these, they're kind of like a dark dimension. Once you have all the required materials, you can enter. And I guess you're not missing too much, I guess, is a positive way to look at it, because he's not that good. But it does suck that more players aren't able to unlock him, especially if you've been playing this long, chasing for this long, doing all these milestones for this long, and not having that. So hopefully they infuse more L4, T2 level 4 ions into the economy, because that is the big bottleneck right now for everybody chasing Apocalypse. All right, I have another question. What is it, my friend? What are the best T4 abilities for Ultimate X-Men, and what is the best ISO 8 for each? All right, so I'll show you what I have on mines, and with a disclaimer, this may or may not be the best version, but it's been pretty successful for me. Whenever I use them, they are pretty good. So back to the game here, Phantom X. These, I only have one T4 on him. It is the passive. He has some pretty good ones. This is an okay one if you're really looking for the damage. I was kind of waiting till I got more stars in him. I probably might do this one, more stars. But I think the only one that you may need is this one right here, the passive for Phantom X. Rogue's a great character. I did all the T4s for Rogue. And back to the ISO 8. He is a skirmisher, I believe, right? Yeah, skirmisher for Phantom X. And I think I did that skirmisher just because initially he needed that extra focus. Rogue is a striker and she has all the T4s. Gambit is a raider. He has the T4s on his passive, ultimate, and his special. We also have Dazzler here. She is also a skirmisher, because She needs that extra focus. She needs that extra focus to land her ability blocks and everything like that. So she has the T4 on her passive and her ultimate. And last but not least is Sunfire with the T4s on his special ultimate passive. And he is also a raider here. He has a big, big AU attack. And that is what I have for my unlimited X-Men. If you guys have some different ISO 8s and the reason why you have these ISO 8 classes on him or different T4s, let me know, or not just him, on any of these unlimited X-Men, let me know in the comments, guys. But that is what I have for them right now, brother. So hopefully that helps you. All right, Valley. My alliance recently suffered a painful loss in Alliance Wars. Most of our TCPs exceeded theirs, but they had so many Gammas on defense, it was rough. Other than a mirror match, what teams can topple the mighty Gamma team in war? There's a few different options for a double tap. I know if you go in with Infinity Watch or anything that really could pull that ultimate from Red Hulk, that second tap is a lot easier. Weapon X can take him out like that. I know you said not a mirror match, but I guess technically there's not a mirror match. You take out Abomination, put in Dormammu for that Gamma team. They could take them out as well, but yeah, it's kind of a mirror match. But I guess the best option, I guess, is going to be, and this breaks up a lot of teams, so I don't know if you want to use this one as well, but Gamma's pretty strong on defense, so you may have to. But Weaver 2099, Dormammu, Hela, and Zombie Iron Man. So that's a good one. That'll beat them for you. But, you know, you're breaking up a bunch of good teams as well. But like I said, that you may need that because you're facing the Gamma team, which is the war team. All right, moving on. Wow, 108 straight up offers to sell me crap I neither want, or this doesn't include all the hidden offers when you're collecting character material, fine, and even more offers. I would have considered myself a small to middle dolphin spending between 20 to 60 pounds a month, and I have not spent a single penny on the game since Christmas, actually using my hard-earned cash to buy other things that I can enjoy. Yes, yeah, I don't see the question there, but I don't see a lot of great things to buy right now either. I hope Scopely makes things a little more generous. I usually spend a little bit more when they're more generous, but when they do events tied to spending, not being able to complete milestones, events that characters, you know, that use characters that you have to buy, those kind of things make me spend a little less. Some people, they might have that FOMO and spend more, but for me, it makes me spend less. So, yeah. One more question. When is Drew the Rumor Guy coming back? Do you think Too Many Frosted got the best of him? I mean, he's looking that way, right? I hope he comes back. I missed that guy, but I don't know if he has rumors, but we're gonna find a way to bring him back on the channel because I think the rumors have kind of dried up for Drew the Rumor Guy and a lot of other rumor people in Marvel Strike Force. All right, so let's party. 5 years of mailbag videos, guys. Take a bow, my friend. I don't know, it's been 5 years of coming Marvel Strike Force. We didn't start the mailbag videos in year one, but thank you, my friend. We have surpassed the milestone since we didn't celebrate my last time, but now we will. 21 for 21. Yeah, brother. I would tell you to go back to my video, watch our first question, but not sure if you have it up. That's how long it's, yeah, I don't know where it is. It's been a while, my friend. Been proud. X-Factor, blind prediction, and you kept rolling. Appreciate you, Valley. Ben helped me through a lot. The fact that you answered every one of my questions means something to me. Sorry to hijack this thread, but you should know the Freeborn community loves the heck out of you. Just thought you should. Thank you, my brother. Oh, there is a question. Why isn't Agatha Farmville? I'm not sure. I thought always it was always just greed and they just wanted to be greedy. But I don't know. I think it's kind of hurting them at this point with that. So I don't know. We'll just go with the standard answer. They're greedy. They want to make money on Sunfire and Agatha, and they're going to be Farmville later this year. Icarus took a year, so Agatha will take a little over a year, I guess. I don't know. It's silly. Hey Valley, I hope I'm not too late. Quick question regarding my skill raid team. I'm having the meta skill team at the moment, but gear 14, blue ISO 3. Should I switch gears to this new skill team because I can't seem to get through more of the one note with this team? Maria and or Sharon usually get nukes on opening turn because their health isn't top enough. All right, so this is an interesting question right now. It's about building for right now or building for the future because you're hurting one of the others right now. So if you wait right now, save all your gear, put it on the next skill team, this Invaders team, you're gonna hurt your raids right now. But if you put all your gear on your current Secret Avengers teams, building up your Sharon and your Maria to do the raids right now, you know, you're using up your gear and hurting your speed at which you build up your invader. So I don't know what the right answer is. I guess it depends on if you're more interested in the short term or the long term, because it's a double-edged sword here, brother. It's either one. If it was me, though, I would just hold off, sacrifice a little bit on the right now, and start building towards the future, put on the invader. So hopefully that helps you. I don't know if that's the right answer for everybody, but that's what I would do. All right, and last not least, this one came in as we recorded this. How are you doing, my brother? Hope your injuries from the recent fall is healed. It is, and I got my teeth fixed as well. I don't know if you can see that, but it's not chipped anymore. We got it to the dentist before we left. So thank you, my brother. I have a couple of questions. More request suggestion than a question. All right. We are in a top 100 rated Lions, doing 3.5 twice a week. I'm with his Alliance close to doing 4 to 5 months. But within a span of 10 days, the old members in my Alliance either retired or moved out to Lower Doom Alliance. Gets the MSF lag hitting him. And I'm thinking a lot of the fatigue from Apocalypse and the letdown from Apocalypse is hurting a lot of the community right now. So I don't know. Hopefully Scopely has some things on the horizon that they're going to do for this 5th anniversary or something like that. And they make it known public, because the PR regarding this 5th anniversary is not very good right now. All right, so recently I was browsing through our old trusty MSF recruitment Discord servers and found there's no channel post 18 million TCP. If you knew someone from those recruiting servers, could you please ask them to update their channels? I hope there are more people around 20 to 30 million TCP now. So I'm not sure which server this is, but I know on the main one, I think Thorn, who's a moderator of my Discord, is also moderating that, so I'll reach out to him. If it's another server that I don't know the moderator of, then I'm not sure. But I mean, if it's a particular server that you want, I think you could reach out to all the mods there saying, hey, can you add this other channel? It's pretty simple to do. But yeah, I will reach out to Thorn about the main MSF server there. Additionally, I recently find my Alliance falling apart. So often I see people running in circles, not knowing how to find or post in recruitment channels. Would be helpful for many. The big CC like you, a mobile gamer, showed how people find those Discord recruitment servers and apply them to your needs. Keep on rocking. So yeah, so normally when I look to recruit, I just go to the recruitment channel on my server, and there's a lot of people there that are looking. I find it's more of a seller's market than a buyer's market. You know, they just say it's easier to find an Alliance if you're looking, and find a pretty good Alliance if you're looking, rather than try to recruit for Alliance. It's a lot harder to try to get people in to Alliance because people are leaving, and I think a lot of that is to do that Apocalypse burnout. All right, so that is it, guys. Hopefully this update is good. Hopefully there's some good things on the horizon. Hopefully Apocalypse rework is good as well, and he lives up to that expectation of this long-awaited chase for this character. And thank you to everybody that left a question on this Monday mailbag. Again, if you want to leave a question for one of these future Monday mailbags, make sure you are a member of the Discord. The link is down below. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great rest of your week. Hopefully this update is good, and I'll see you guys next time. Hulk fist bump. Valley flying out.